Buongiorno, televisionette. I'm Jake Bugg, I'm a singer-songwriter from Clifton, Nottingham.
Morning, it's another pure grey morning. Don't know what the day is holding. And I get up right home and I walk right into the path of a lightning bolt.
My album came out in October in the UK. And I'm just currently, you know, trying to promote that album. And I just made it, you know. Like, if people like it, then that's great, and if not, then I don't care, so.
Met her as the angels parted for her. She only brought me torture. That's what happens when it's you that's standing in the path of a lightning bolt.
Well, as soon as I picked up the guitar, I knew that it's what I wanted to do. Whether or not I would be doing it as a career, I didn't think would be possible. But because I thought about it so many times and dreamt of it, that when it became a reality, it didn't seem that strange.
Everyone I see just walks the walk with gritted teeth, but I just stand by and I wait my time. They say you gotta toe the line. They want the water, not the wine. But when I see the signs, I'll jump on that lightning bolt.
So everything started with Don McLean's Vincent.
When I heard that song on The Simpsons, it was the first time I actually liked a piece of music. I didn't like music before then, and it was certainly the start of me listening to more music. Lightning Bolt is about everything was kind of going so fast, and it's a very fast song, and so I called it Lightning Bolt.
I drink to remember, I smoke to forget, some things to be proud of, some stuff to regret.
That line is irony, isn't it? And you know, it's an opening line. And that song is about, it's quite a personal song. It's about, you know, my experiences of being brought up and things I experienced and just what I generally do in my area.
I go back to Clifton to see my old friends, the best people I could ever have met. Skin up a fat one, hide from the feds. There's something that's changing, changing, changing. So I kiss goodbye to every little ounce of pain. Light a cigarette and wish the world away. I got out, I'm alive and I'm here to stay.
I have a lot of influences, certainly. Like a lot of old blues, like Robert Johnson and Sunhouse and Muddy Waters and to the Beatles and Jimi Hendrix and Neil Young. Yeah, it's an ongoing list.
You supported the Stone Roses and Noel Gallagher's gigs. What does it mean for you to have such important fans?
Well, it's very inspiring that someone that's been an influence takes a genuine interest in what you do. I love to write songs and I like to perform as well. I just really enjoy writing songs.
And the worst part?
The worst. This.
I was sure.
It's not so bad, you know. It's great that people are interested in what you do and want to hear what you have to say and how you went about what you're doing. So, you know, it's part of it. And I understand that by doing this, you know, like, there'll be people that might be introduced to my music through this one interview that might not necessarily have been introduced to it any other way.
Gonna sing you an old country song from the heart, so I can cry your name and call you when I'm sad.
Well, I woke up one morning and I looked out my window and it was very grey outside and not very pleasant, and it was raining, and I just thought I wanted to be somewhere else and in a different situation that I'd never experienced before. and I just put three chords together, and that's how it came about.
Will I see you again? Please just come on back home.
You know, one of the most influential pieces of advice would be from a local DJ in BBC Nottingham. It was said, for every two-step forward, there's a step back. So whenever I think things aren't going so well, I just tell myself that, you know, there'll be another two-step forward.
Gonna sing you an old country song from the...
Do you have a dream?
Yeah, I'm living it.